Hello, welcome back to Let's Play The Sea Will Claim Everything. I'm Amethyst Notari, the RPG chick. This game is very interesting. We're heading into Oi's Inn to ask the innkeeper if he has any leftovers for this guy who's hungry. Let's look around in here first. We're out here. These plants really do grow everywhere. A two-headed flower. Oi's Inn, the finest place to eat, drink, and rest in Port Darragh. A bottle of vintage Miravor. A werebee's wax candle. You don't fit in there. No kidding. Talk to this mouse. Lou looks scurry. Hmm? Oh, hi. Smell the day is Rodentia. Let's ask him about himself. I'm Lou. I suppose I'm pronouncing that right? Lou? Not Lug or Lug? Lou McScurry. Lou of the McScurry family. That's me. I run the inn in the inn. I'm a mouse. We're very fast. Have to be, actually. I'm quite relaxed for a mouse. You should see my cousin Kevin. Always running and nibbling. No time for a nice pint. Or my other cousin, Brian. Got eaten by an eagle. Never comes by anymore. That's about the town. Nice town. Very nice. My family helped found it, I think. Many generations ago. Always lived here. Life is hard now. Not much cheese. What about the inn and the inn? The inn and the inn is the small inn for mice, rats, other rodents, very small humans, sometimes ants. We eat, drink, laugh. Sometimes people stay very long, a whole hour. I'm the innkeeper. I stay here all the time, except at night. I like cheese. Alright, let's go in. Hello there. We got a snake. And, I guess that's a stag, a deer. Possibly. A moose, maybe. Oh, look, a deer with the antlers. It smells like there was a pretty strong cocktail in there. No wonder Phidias is smiling. Dr. Phidias. Alright, I clicked on some kind of staff that he was around, but now I'm in talking with him, so I'll just talk to him. Smell of the day. Oh, smell of the day is healing herbs. Greetings, stranger. How may I be of assistance? I'm not gonna do the S's. It's gonna annoy people. He's asking about himself. I am Dr. Phidias, traveling physician from the Isle of the Sun. I travel so that I may learn from the wisdom of others. There can be no healing without knowledge. Jellification potion. Right. Jellification potions. Yes, I do know how to make them. They can be most useful in preparing certain ingredients. Here, I will copy the recipe for you. Good luck. Alright, I gotta check our scroll. One second. Healing Underhome. Underhome has been assaulted? The outrage. I was hoping to visit the mysterious druid to speak of biotechnology. Whatever is the world coming to. But I will do my best to help you heal the damage. I will give you my recipe for the soup of recovery. Cook this in Underhome's kitchen and let it absorb the fumes. Excellent, cool. The ingredients will be hard to find, but the cause is worthy. Alright, we need hard to find ingredients. Arterial cleaning device. An arterial cleaning device? Sadly, I do not know how to make such a thing. Perhaps you should inquire on the Isle of the Stars. Alright, let's check the scroll. See what's going on. The recipe scroll has been updated. Okay, so I've got two new potions. Potion of Jellification. The liquid's base must be prune juice, to which add impossible fluoric and repulsive squish leaf to create a potion of glob. Now refine with onion-based water extract. Super recovery. In Underhome's kitchen, cook the following ingredients. Salmon of Wisdom, bacteriolytic Baharat, hair of the dog, carrot, and leek. I know where to find carrots. Oh, maybe I can find this stuff in the fridge. Now that I have something. I have a reason to look around all in the fridge. And there's a bunch of bottles and things here. Bottle of Spice Bravari. He loves this Bravari stuff. Absinthe with a hint of green moat should only be ingested in minute quantities. Perpendicular Polk, oak-flavored Ent Drought, a big bottle of Glendular Slairn, a small bottle of Splurg. A medicinal smelling whiskey. Distilled goulash. A minty sort of drinky. Aliantha juice. Wine from southern Pagana. Locally produced cherry juice. An empty beer keg. This keg is completely empty. Got some glasses. So it says glasses. Whiskey by Janet Jackson. Fawn by Terry Fawn. Dog Puncher's Cocktail Guide by Dog Puncher. Okay, there was another author from another book was Horse Puncher. Who is punching animals? The Innkeeper's Book of Autobiographical Insight by Emmy Wagner. A pile of magazines for guests to read. As is usually the case, most of them are unspeakably dull. Oi keeps some of his more exotic drinks in there. Some cups here. Cups from the Cirque du Soleil. These glasses were a gift from Oi's friend Basil, an innkeeper in odd misstanding. Bob the Spider is in two of these glasses. Okay. I think we've seen everything here. Oi Stagson. Welcome to Oi's Inn. Relax, have a drink. Smell the day is fur. Let's ask him about himself. When I was younger, I was afraid that my malformed arm would mean that I couldn't be an innkeeper, but as it turns out, I can do the job quite well. I'm very proud of what the inn means to Port Darragh, even though the crisis means that fewer people now come here. What about the inn? My family has run this inn for many generations. It is a place of rest and relaxation for many a weary traveler, and also the place where the townspeople come to talk, drink, and celebrate. We share the building with Lug's Inn in the inn. Talk to him outside. Drinks. Oh, we have a very solid selection. Nothing like what you'd get in Oneropolis, of course, but probably the best you'll find in the Fortunate Isles. Barley wine, Miravor, butterbeer, many different kinds of whiskey. I believe we have a bottle of Welleran's finest somewhere, and a discerning customer may be interested in our Serenarian stout. What about foods? We've got all the traditional meals, though what I'd really recommend is our baked eel monster with crunchy potatoes and garlic. If you are more partial to salads like myself, I recommend the grass salad with small insects. It's my mother's recipe, and I promise it tastes equally good every time it comes back up. Okay. Well, let's ask Sir Patrick. He needs some food. Why doesn't he just come in and talk to me? What is it with all this shyness? It's completely unnecessary. These are hard times, and people should help each other. Here, give him this and tell him to stop being silly. Will do. Got a meal for Patrick. Food for Patrick. Touch. Smell. It smells delicious, or he must be a very good cook. The mouse says it's very happy for Patrick. And here's the part where I save the game, so I don't mess things up by trying to eat it, because I want to see what it says. You can't eat Patrick's food. Good game. Yeah, another meal. I just get unlimited meals. Now I think back will go out, so I'm going to go this way. Always in dining area. Yeah, a bunch of pictures. Portraits. An old picture of the lighthouse outside town. A reproduction of Brian Blessed's famous photo of a desert yeti. A famous ruin that Oi once visited. A great king was crowned here, but few remember his name. An ancient temple near Billion Toad City. A picture of Thou's great uncle Claudius in the ruins of Bumbasharna. He was good friends with Oi's father. A picture of a famous three-headed writer who once stayed in Oi's inn for several weeks to work on a trilogy of books. Did each head work on a separate book? It's some sort of henge here on the Isle of the Moon. A photo from the dangerous land of Tetris, where blocks of stone continuously fall from the sky. One of the stranger places in the world. An empty bottle. A werebear earwax candle. Alright. These flowers got so hungry they ate the other flowers' description. The menu. The potato dishes are particularly good. Some ontological spoons. These knives are quite knifey. A solitary salt shaker. If you need to use a toilet, please use the one on the side on your side of the window. Is that a toilet? The strongest coffee you've ever smelled. A very sweet wine that smells of Tirnsa come by flowers. Whatever it is, it contains a lot of alcohol. A very expensive wine from Mournhold. Elder Scrolls reference. A bottle of brown Bavari. The Bavari all over the place. Babylon 5 reference. It's a drink that the Centauri have. And Lando Malari, one of the ambassadors on Babylon 5, had a old friend come up to the station, and he brought a bottle of fine Bavari. And then he proceeded to tell Lando that he calls him Passo Liati because he fights like a crazed Liati. It's one of my favorite scenes. It's just so... They're so, like, I don't know, like, Italian, only, like, it's a parody of Italian. Salt and pepper shakers. The salt is in the pepper shaker, and the pepper is in the salt shaker. That would be confusing. This is an X cocktail. It's funny I can't look at the flowers. Interesting, huh? Stacked menus. That sounds like it has some sort of special meaning, doesn't it? But it's just menus that are on top of one another in a horizontal position. Select to Mananan MacLear. What? Smell of the day is booze with a hint of seawater. He's asking about himself. It's all gone. All gone. The ship, the horse, the cloak, the sword. No more riding the waves, no more great adventures, no more guiding, no more. Just this now. Replaced me with a hydrofoil, they did. Really. Rendered me to Tartarus. But I escaped. Ha! Hick. Didn't do me much good. He's asking about Magmel. That is. Not what, like, it used to be. It used to be... Hick. It used to be great. It used to be like coming out of a storm and finding a place of perfect calm. Like the secret places underwater where the octopuses hold their councils. Like that. Now it's poor, but very competitive. We're very proud of being very competitive. Work for food, make toys for tourists, little action figures of old heroes. One of me too. Hick, there used to be no hunger. He's asking about Niam. My great-granddaughter? She was here. I remember. She said something. I remember. She said... I forgot. No, wait. She went to the Isle of the Sun. I wish I could have given her my old karak. Maybe I need more ale. I don't know what that karak is. Alright, so my scroll has been updated. That's easy, he's right outside. Bring Patrick the food. Find the am on the Isle of the Sun. Alright. So we'll back out, we'll go this way, give him the food. A full meal? Oh wow, I didn't... And he says, I didn't expect so much kindness. Sorry, I don't want to embarrass you getting all emotional here. It's just that no one's really done this kind of thing for me before. I always thought the world was, you know, dog-eat-dog and all that. Thank you, both of you. You and Oi. Oh, would you like to have this? It's an ancient token of some kind. I found it hidden in one of my uncle's old shoes. Patrick's token. Excuse me. A token of the tomb of the treasure tyrant. Spin it around a few times. It's shiny. It smells of leprechaun. Eat. It probably won't hurt you, but you might need it, and then you'll have to wait until it comes back out. The mouse doesn't really care about this token. Excellent. Okay. Alright, so we're done with this stuff then. Go back this way. We've been to the main square. I'm not gonna go in that building yet. Look in the harbor. Stack crates containing goods from all around the Fortunate Isles. A huge barrel. It contains water for long voyages. These plants are very hardy. This is where Joel the Harbor Master lives. This bird is lost in thought. Okay. Go further this way. Alright, there is a seagull with a hat on here. Rope. Sailors love ropes. A terrible crate containing terrible sardines. That's the name of the species. Not a statement about their quality. The crate really is terrible, though. A very big crate containing various goods from the Isle of the Stars. There's also a crab here. No one knows what this rope is attached to. A pretty little ship. If you had one of these, you could travel all around the Fortunate Isles. Alright. Not much to look at here then, huh? Let's check out the crab. Mr. Crab. Dudachum? Smell the day his fingers. That's him about the town. Did a chick? He's asking about himself. Dadachok? What about debt? Dadacham? What about the Fortunate Isles? Debt a check. Right. Captain Pelargos. Ahoy, traveler. Smell the day is sea breeze. Help? I see you have come a long way, and your journey is likely to take you all across the Fortunate Isles. I would therefore like to offer my ship to you in exchange for your help. You almost certainly know that our island is in debt, and though the causes are hard to understand, the results are likely to be terrible. I'm an old stork who understands little of economics, but I believe I may have found the solution to our problems. The treasure of the Tomb of the Timber Tyrant. If you promise to help me find it, my ship is yours for as long as you are here. Yes? Excellent. Okay. That's about the town. A sailor always needs a place to return to. You cannot travel if you do not have a place to travel away from or to travel towards. A mermaid once told me it's the same with eternity and mortal life. Okay, what about this timber tyrant? The timber tyrant was a cruel ruler who rose from these isles many years ago to enslave his own people and conquer the world. He is often thought only a myth now, but I have reason to believe he was quite real. And if he is real, then his treasure must be real. And with that treasure, our debt could be paid. Token? This token, which was given to me by my grandmother when I was but a hatchling, may be an important clue. I believe others here in Port Darragh have similar tokens, and if the tales are true, then they are somehow related to the tyrant and his resting place. About the ship. She's all yours, though before you take her out, you might want to get a good compass. I don't have one, since we storks can navigate by the internal compass nature has blessed us with. But I'm sure you will be able to find one here on the Isle of the Moon. Oh, and a sextant is equally invaluable. You should have both before you set out. Okay. Ask him about himself. Why would a stork need a boat, you may wonder, if he can fly? Because I love the sea, of course, and because I'm afraid of heights. Okay. You got Captain Pelargos' token. Captain Pelargos' token? The token of Captain Pelargos. The token of the Tomb of the Treasure Tyrant. You spin it around a few times. It's shiny. Wait. That's Patrick's token. Okay, look at the Captain's token. Same. This one smells of feathers, though. Same thing, if you eat it, mouse doesn't care about the token. Okay. Well, can I ask him about the timber tyrant now, Domachum? Right. Let's go in this, whatever this is. The door seems to be stuck. You're pretty sure this is the town hall, though. Alright. We've had a bunch of stuff in our scroll. Let me see what else is going on. Find a doctor who can help you build a tool for cleaning Underhome's arteries. Gather the ingredients for the soup of recovery. Find a repulsive squish leaf. Find all the tokens of the Tomb of the Timber Tyrant. Locate the Tomb of the Timber Tyrant. Can't go that way. Let's back out towards this guy. Let me go this way. Oh, it's an empty stall. Mayor Penglog's financial measures have forced the merchant who used this stand to close it down. This mushroom used to be blue, but seeing what happened to the nice merchant who worked here has turned it red. This one thinks the other mushrooms are being too political. It's just inappropriate, it says. This one's reading Mushroominess and the Urban Experience by David Harvey, an upstanding mushroom. Alright, so there's nothing else to look here. I can go back this way, though. Oh. Okay. Can I ask him about the town hall? Yeah, town hall door. The door only opens if you push it a bit to the left while you're opening it. It would be easy to fix it, but for some reason the mayor won't let me. I don't understand why he doesn't believe I can do it. Hmm. What about the token? I don't have something like that. I don't think so. Maybe you should ask my father. Okay, so now we gotta ask everybody about a token. Salmon of Wisdom. Salmon of Wisdom? Ah, how unfortunate. I have so many types of fish, but sadly none of that. If you had come just a few days ago, a few years ago, I could have provided a magnificent specimen. But when Mayor Penglog took over, he brokered a deal with a fishery on the mainland, and they sent their boats here and caught so much salmon that we never saw any again. What about a token? Token. Oh, that little thing. I gave it to Borin in exchange for an Atlantean scratching post. It was a little dilapidated, but I fixed it up, and it's been absolutely worth it. Jellification. Oh, the possibilities. I do hope you manage to find or make that potion. Okay. Borin, okay. What about the token? I would give it to you for free if I still had it, but sadly I do not. I traded it to a traveler from the Isle of Stars a few weeks ago. I'm afraid you will have to go there if you wish to retrieve the token. Sextant? A sextant. Yes, I do believe I have one. I'll trade it to you for an amulet. Not any amulet, of course, but one that I lost some time ago and would dearly love to recover. I left it in Olwynion when last I was there to trade, before the town was abandoned. It is not precious, so perhaps it is still there, where the market used to be. A foolish hope, perhaps, but what do we have these days but foolish hopes? Anyway, I would be grateful if you went and looked. It's a long way to walk for an old dwarf. If it's not there, I'll give you the sextant anyway. That's cool. Olwynion? Olwynion was the old wheelwright's village up north in a valley beyond the shadowy glen. A nice place, quiet, perhaps a little too quiet. It was the first place to be struck down by the debt. Its people forced to live a life so frugal that they had to abandon their homes. Perhaps we should have seen it as a warning that the same would be done to Port Darragh. Certainly the frugality did not help them. When the village was abandoned, its debt was higher than ever, and all the land was claimed by Lord Urizen. Okay, the map has been updated, so Olwynion is here. Okay, let's continue this way. Let's ask her about a token. The token? Yes, I have one. It was given to me by my mother, who said it was very valuable, though not in its materials. I see you need it for a quest you believe to be meaningful, but I cannot simply hand it over. Of course not. If only because my mother would kill me if she found out. Might I propose an exchange? The token for a wild subnana fruit. I can't afford to buy them from the mainland anymore, but if you could find me a wild one, I could plant a tree in my cellar. The cultivated variety has been magically altered not to have seeds, you see, so that people can't grow them on their own. So wild subnana is very valuable. Enough that my mother won't complain too much about the token. Find a wild one. So it can't be one that's inside the home, the underhome? I'll go there anyway, I guess. I wish this, like, added in order. Is he even in here? Can you... Yeah, I'll see it there. Wait a second. Oh, we can, oh my god, I have so many things to do. Find a... I didn't even know this was down here. Find a sextant, find a compass, determine whether Boron's amulet is still in Willian. Get a subnana fruit for Anaria. Find the person on the Isle of Stars that Boron gave Catnip's token to. Can you make a cookie for the thoughtful lizard that's been there? Get a carrot leek. Find some hot peppers. Get the hair of the dog. This is for, like, potions, things. That, well, the carrot and leek are for the, soup. Maybe the hot peppers, too. Get bacteriolytic baharet. Find the salmon of wisdom. New carpet for underhome. Fix underhome's humidity settings. Those last two have been there. Good, there's no more right now. My god. You have a token? Token? Yes, given to me by my grandfather last month. Very nice. You want to have it? Find treasure? I'll exchange it. Barter system. Bring me cheese. Special cheese. Port Darragh flaming cheddar. Used to be traditional. No one makes it now. If you get it, I will make a feast. A feast for all the mice in Port Darragh. To lift our spirits. A good cause, yes? So I got... Here we go, cheese. Recipe for a traditional Port Darragh flaming cheddar. I have a feeling I've been playing this game for a long time, guys. So I can't ask the snake, Dr. Phidias, about a token. What about this guy? A token, you say? Yes, I do have such a thing somewhere here. I'm not quite sure where. Look, if you do me a favor, I'll take some time to try and find it. With that old man drinking so much, I've almost entirely run out of my good beer, which I get from the brewery in the Glen. You seem to be capable of carrying quite a lot in that window of yours, so if you could go get me some, I'd really appreciate it. Tell the brewer that I sent you. What? Flaming cheddar. Flaming cheddar. I'm sorry, I have no idea how to make that. I've heard of it, but I don't think I've ever eaten any, or seen any for that matter. I think it has something to do with one of the ingredients suddenly becoming hard to find, but I don't remember what it was. Oh, lovely. Patrick, what a silly boy. What about this guy? I can't ask him about a token. Okay, we got inside the, hall. It says Mayor's Office inside. There's a skull here with a mustache. It's private property, stay away. Penglog's beloved lucky golf ball. How to eat everything and make others pay the bill, a guide to metaphorical eating by Theodoros Pangalos. There's only a couple books, guys, like seven of this or something. 10 New Approaches to Creating Profitable Inequity by Lucas Papademos. Genocide Takes Commitment by Angelus Merkel. How to Impersonate Others for Fine and Fun and Profit by Filthy Jones. I can't even look at that book. The Virtue of Selfishness, A New Concept of Egoism by Ayn Rand. The Jackals of Evil by Terry Goodkind. A photo of Penglog playing golf. Even the photo is tedious. Penglog's prize for winning the Barrington Elite Golf Championship. You'll never know what's in there. Thanks. Property. The substances stored in there are completely harmless, really. Please keep your hands off these private medical supplies. Right. Mayor Plenglog's Diploma of Advanced Post-Historical Economic Management Consultancy from the University of Plegiatinin. The planned Port Darragh Golf Club. Careful, each of these golf clubs costs as much as you'll earn in a year. A shiny distraction. A stamp that has the authority to control people's lives. These feathers from the rare gray Pegasus were a personal gift to Mayor Plenglog from Lord Urizen. Approved green ink made by squeezing baby octopuses. Aww. Papers authorizing the firing of public sector workers, cuts in pensions, and a major bailout for Penglog Golfing Incorporated. Alright. Mayor Penglog. My time is limited. Smell of the day is red tape. Asking about himself. I think of myself as a patriot, not in the nationalist sense, of course, but as someone who has the best interests of Port Darragh in mind. Hard choices have to be made, and it will take courage to bring Port Darragh into the future. I am confident that our actions will lead through the current dry spell to a brighter future. We will work hard and overcome our troubles, I am confident. For all legal purposes, these statements are to be taken as being of an inspirational nature. Economic results may vary. Excuse me. Ask about the Isle of the Moon. We are the tiger of the fortunate isles, charging forward and never stopping, like a shark, inspired by freedom and hard work to reach for greater heights. We are inspired by our friends on the mainland and ready to cut all excess fat. We will not let red tape and the leeches of society allow the tiger to stop charging forward like a shark. Growth matters, and Port Darragh embodies growth. What about poverty? The problem is not poverty, but an overabundance of wealth, which has strangled the fire within that is our desire to competitively rise to the top of a challenging but necessary mountain of business, standing instead in the lush valleys below and never wondering why our flocks are dying. What we need is to make sure that the burden of the shepherd is lightened so he may better lead, and the burden of the sheep is increased so it is motivated to reach the top of the mountain. Sure. What about Underholm? Are you suggesting that as organized and efficient an organization as the Bank of Yarn would initiate foreclosure proceedings by accident? They process thousands of foreclosures per day. It is extremely irrational to suggest that they would not be highly proficient at this. Perhaps your friend has merely misunderstood something. Recently, a one-time tax on some types of property was instituted, according to Mayoral Decision 55B, the processing of which was handled by the aforementioned bank. Should this be the case, once the foreclosure is complete, you can submit two forms, one to me and one to a representative of the bank, stating that an error may have occurred. If the bank agrees, the issue will be investigated within the next 48 months. 4 years. Scroll is updated. Return to the mysterious druid and tell him about Mayor Penglog's nonsensical response. Exactly. Yeah, I asked that. Alright. Thanks for watching, guys. When next we meet, I will return to the Underhome, get one of those bananas, and tell the mysterious druid what we have found here. Thanks for watching, and this is Nord Pudding.